Welcome to SGMD, treating cancer with marijuana. I'm going to show you why some doctors don't think it's such a crazy idea. You know, I get asked a lot, is medical marijuana just a hoax, an excuse to smoke pot? Well, it's true. You know, some doctors are going to prescribe it for just about anything. But when I dug into this, I also found something else. Serious physicians out there who think cannabis could become a real tool to fight all sorts of things, including cancer.
Good job.
Landon Riddle was a normal two-year-old boy until he was diagnosed with leukemia.
They told us he doesn't look sick, very sick to, you know, to y'all, but, you know, he's on the brink of death.
Doctors in Salt Lake City immediately started intense chemotherapy and radiation.
But told us that he probably wasn't going to make it, that he only had like an 8% chance to live 24 to 48 hours.
The chemo made him violently ill. He was in intense pain. He suffered nerve damage in his legs, and he went 25 days without eating.
Around the clock, he's usually on liquid morphine, Ativan, promethazine, and it just really didn't seem to be helping.
And then she heard about medical marijuana.
We didn't have anything else to lose.
One chemical in marijuana, THC, is responsible for the psychoactive effects, or the high. It also combats nausea and pain. But another chemical, called CBD, seems to have additional benefits.
Love you.
In January, Landon began taking both as an oil.
As soon as we started doing the oil, his platelets have been above normal for a cancer patient. They've been at a regular, healthy person's level, and they can't understand why.
And it's this effect that has intrigued researchers. In San Francisco, these researchers say that compound, CBD, can kill cancer cells and stop them from metastasizing in human cells and mice, at least in the lab.
This compound that appears to be quite effective at inhibiting cancer in the dish.
And they're ready now to take the next step, which is large-scale clinical trials. Of course, many cancer therapies do make it to this step, and some say it is too early to get excited.
So we're at a place now where there aren't enough data. We're beginning to gather more. And I think, as in so many things, people are now beginning to demand other treatment options.
Now, it's worth pointing out Landon has been off chemo for 3 weeks. And whether or not the cannabis actually played a role, his mother says his leukemia is currently in remission. So is marijuana bad for you? That's the other question. Or can pot actually do some good? I traveled all over the world looking for answers to these questions, and you're going to see what I uncovered. That's Sunday, August 11th, 8 p.m. Eastern, right here on CNN.